guys, my name is Laura. I'm going to go through a Leaving Cert history essay with you today from the 2016 paper. It's from the Pursuit of Sovereignty and the Impact of Partition topic, and it's the question about Irish social and economic problems. Now, guys, you can see there that I'm going to dip in and dip out of different parts of the essay and different things relating to the essay. So I do recommend before I get into it that you have a quick read of the entire essay yourself, just to put it into your head so it's all a bit clearer as I start talking about it. Now, I'm not going to talk about every single paragraph, guys, but there will be a fully annotated PDF of the essay on StudyClix afterwards if you'd like a little bit more detail on it. Now, firstly, to look at the actual question itself. You know yourselves you have to make your choice on your Leaving Cert paper as quick as you possibly can, and you have to be as clear about all of the boxes that you have to tick for the examiner. So firstly, always keep an eye out for dates. You must cover the entirety of the dates that are mentioned. Of course, it's important then to give a bit of context, in this instance, pre-1923, but you have to make sure that you go all the way up to 1945, and that will be stated on the marking scheme as well. Make sure as well you note, and I know this may seem obvious, guys, but people do make this mistake. It says governments. So in this instance, you're going to be talking about Cumann na Gael and Fianna Fáil. So just watch out for that. That word cope I've highlighted there because it's the key word that I need to keep referring back to. And it's a word I possibly need to kind of explore. So sometimes it's not quite as clear cut with these, you know, political parties, how well they might have coped. So you can ask yourself things like, how successful were they? How efficient were they? Were they fair? Were their actions long lasting? Who did they benefit? Did they benefit everyone? And, you know, in looking at those kind of questions, you can say, well, in this, because of all of this, they coped very well with these problems. But I have to keep going back to that. In relation to the actual marking scheme, and just following on from what I've said there, a couple of things to have a little think about. The examiners, when they're starting to correct your essays, are told to make sure you look at how the candidate, that's you, treats the set question. The set question. Not the question that you hope was asked or that you wish was asked. Are you answering the question that is actually asked on the day? Okay. And if you keep referring back to, in this instance, what I said there about cope, and the different questions you can ask yourself, then you are treating the set question. And then, are you giving accurate and substantial information in relation to that set question? Those are just a couple of things to keep in your mind, guys, in relation to the marking scheme, as you write your own essays, as you read back over your own essays, and of course, as you read any of the sample answers that are available to you. So now let's look at this specific sample answer and do they do all the things that I've just talked about. This is not a bad introduction. The phrasing is good and all of that, but I would like if it gave a little bit more context about the long period of unrest that Ireland had gone through pre-1923, just to set the scene a little bit more. Now, the Civil War is mentioned in paragraph one, which I'm going to talk about shortly. But really, I think a lot of that information belongs in the intro. You know, what was going on in Ireland before this that meant that there were social and economic problems? I think that would make that clearer for the reader. In this instance, and you know yourselves, you have so little time on your Leaving Cert paper, you can use abbreviations, but make sure you introduce them the first time you mention that organisation or whatever it might be. For instance, here, Cumann na Gael, afterwards, the first time you say it there, you can put C na G in brackets afterwards, and then you can just say C na G or FF for Fianna Fáil or any of those things, just to make it a little bit quicker and easier for yourself. And make sure you do introduce the abbreviations. Just something small, but make sure you actually do it, guys. Now, this introduction it's very good. But I would like if, in this instance, it was a little bit clearer about the direction your essay is taking. And what I mean by that is what I've already said, actually, about exploring that word cope. Because if you explore it a little bit more in the introduction, you can keep referring back to it as you go through your essay. So you could say, I'm going to look at how successful and efficient and fair each of the governments were in relation to the social and economic problems they faced when they were in power or something like that. You can find your own language, but I just think that that would make it a little bit clearer for me, the examiner, and you, the writer, about what you have to keep referring back to. Now, firstly, I'm going to look at paragraphs 1 and 2 in this particular essay. This essay is, it's very well written. There's good expression being used and, of course, context. The Civil War had almost bankrupted the new state. So the scene is being set for me there. I think I'd like a little bit more detail on it, as I said, possibly in the introduction, but it's really good that it's mentioned there. I've highlighted this phrase. This was a major blow to the Irish economy, and I feel that that was a slight missed opportunity to refer specifically to the question. So, for example, you could say something like, this was a major blow to the Irish economy and something that Cumann na Gael struggled to cope with. Do you see how you could slip in the words of the set question a little bit more here and there across the essay? Watch out for that. Remember, your Leaving Cert History essays are not just different chunks of information. There is a thread or a link between them. So make that a little bit more explicit here. And these paragraphs could be very easily linked. So, for example, that second paragraph there could start with one of the first issues Cumann na Gael dealt with was agriculture, which was badly hit by the first, you know. So you could really easily link the paragraphs there and create that thread. But I don't want you to think that this essay is very bad. It really is not. There are some excellent statistics and facts and evidence being used. They're very, 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 very accurate. They're very detailed and they're really, really relevant. At the end of that paragraph, it does refer back to the question a bit. It says it was successful in recovering lost British markets by 1930. You know, therefore implying that it coped quite well with this particular problem. But I do feel that that success could be explored a little bit more, because it wasn't a grand turnaround. Yes, some of the British markets returned to buying Irish, but the conditions in Britain were very poor around this time, and you know, they weren't really buying all that much. So yes, Cumann na Gael dealt with it well, but it wasn't this massive success that I feel is kind of implied there. So just be a little bit careful of that, explore that a little bit more. Now I'm going to move down the essay there, guys, just a little bit to paragraphs 8 and 9. The paragraphs are well linked here. Fianna Fáil were more concerned about, you know, so they're saying that they were more concerned about industry than agriculture. The previous paragraph had been about industry, so lovely. In this instance here, those companies, those semi-state bodies are mentioned, and I feel like a little bit of detail on the successes of each of them individually. It does mention in general, just in the sentence after, that the number of industrial jobs had increased by 50%. But I just think that even one or two of those companies could be zoomed in on to really hammer home how successful they were and how Fianna Fáil had used this problem with this kind of lack of industry and how they coped with that through these semi-state bodies. It just could be a little bit more detailed there. The marking scheme, as I mentioned, is very specific when it highlights that you have to deal with the set question. And you're not just telling a story, you are analysing something, you are engaging in historical debate. This paragraph here, where it says this was particularly impressive growth during a time of global economic downturn. So this person is analysing the stuff that they've already said. They're showing awareness of the question. They are implying that Fianna Fáil coped with this problem quite well by using words like impressive. They're saying that they coped with it well. It probably could be a little bit more explicit, but in general, good analytical skills and awareness of the question are shown there. Again, this essay is very good in the accurate and relevant statistics being used that help back up the points being made and the argument being made in relation to each government. Moving on to the final part of the essay, the actual conclusion of the essay as is written there in front of you. We want to leave the examiner with a good summation of the arguments that we have put forward and place our findings in the wider context. Does this essay do that? Now remember, the years that you had to deal with was up to 1945, which, as you know, is the end of World War II. Now, this conclusion here does mention World War II, but really, this isn't the place for it. Now, It does give a good summation of the arguments made and analysis of each government's actions, which I like. The words of the set question are used here as well. That's all fine. But really, a separate paragraph on World War II is needed, and then go into that summation of arguments and the analysis of the actions and using the words of the set question. World War II deserved a paragraph on its own, and how the government, which was Fianna Fáil at the time, how they dealt with the economic and social problems of World War II, the rationing and the Glimmerman and all of that kind of stuff. Really, that should be a separate paragraph on its own, and then a general overall conclusion, which is kind of done here, but it just needs to be after a paragraph on World War II. So guys, that brings me to the end of this essay teardown, which I hope you have found helpful. And remember, all of the paragraphs are analysed for you on StudyClicks if you'd like a bit more detail on the ones that I didn't mention today. Thanks a million, and I'll talk to you all again.